Naruto 605 predictions. Okay, well, first thing we're going to see is that it's going to. This is all a big setup from Madara. As a matter of fact, let's go ahead and switch to the main point here. Who is the main villain of Naruto? Is it? We know it's not Tobi Obito. Okay, he's just a pawn. It's Madara. And while 604 was kind of short, and it ended kind of suddenly, it did show us that it explained that there's this Zetsu communication spy network. The Zetsus, you know, within a certain range can communicate with each other and relay information. And of course, it seems like there's a tremendous amount of these Zetsus. Madara is like a spider in the web. He's connected up to this, and I believe that he is, as many people have observed, not actually sleeping, that he's actually really just connecting with what all these Zetsus are doing. So, just kind of a recap of what happened. So he, as far as his planning things out, he fights in his last battle with the first, which everybody thinks he dies. He manages, he has the statue set in place. He has the Genomazu, he has that plant that I think that the first actually created. Somehow he has that down there. He went ahead and got the DNA he needed to. He got everything set up. But I think he was just simply way, way weaker than he thought that he was going to be. He probably just barely made it, you know. So with him, the Zetsus creating the network, I wouldn't even doubt that he had a hand in killing, actually, what was done to kill the first, the ambush that killed the second, and also, let's go ahead and get back to what's actually been going. Examples, in the Hidden Mist, taking over the Hidden Mist by manipulating the Mizukage, in implementing that hardline military rule, such as Zazuba went and, you know, killed all his classmates, and Danzo and the Hidden Leaf, who kept trying to take over the leaf, these were all connected back to Madara. So Madara, I mean, these are just two examples of him undermining the entire ninja world, trying to control and manipulate, and doing this all in his weakened state through the Zetsus, and what other things. Another thing to remember is he's literally from a different age. This guy's so far back that he has he was a really smart guy, access to a lot of information. So as far as where things were, how things worked, so he had, let's say, things that when he would come in contact beyond just simply, mentally manipulating them, he had things he could trade, you know, through the Zetsus and through whatever agents that he has. So of actual value, pieces of information, locations of artifacts, relics, such things. So anyway, so he would have had a really strong hand, even though he was living in misery in his little spider web. But I just wanted to make sure that we saw 604 not just as a short, quick chapter that ended abruptly, but is really zeroing in on yet another piece of information that shows us that, yes, Madara is the central villain of the entire manga. And until something else comes forward, that's it. He actually, Madara connects so many of the dots. He connects up to so many horrible events that have happened and horrible people that he's created, you know, and manipulated, that I think that this is pretty easy to back up. Well, anyway, I'm going to go ahead and close this short prediction video out, and I think that's what indeed we're going to see. I already have another video on the actual death of Ren for 605. I've had that set out, and of course I'll be doing this week, as I do every week now, a review of comments. Alright, so a thumbs up would be awesome. Really would appreciate it. The channel keeps growing. I appreciate all my viewers. I appreciate all my subscribers. Speaking of that, you can always subscribe. You can always unsubscribe. You can do anything that you want to. Until next time, take care.